You've made a lot of investments in esports at this point. Was there a moment in time where you thought this is going to be big, where you knew that this was going to be a good investment?
I think I would look back to my time in New York in 2015 at the North American League of Legends Championship in Madison Square Garden. I think it was in that moment, not only did I experience personally for myself everything that I'd experienced in the past in playoff environments throughout my NBA days, but I also ran into some of my mentors, Adam Silver being one of them, who was there also exploring the industry, understanding it, and has gone forward, as you've seen yesterday, with the 2K League. So congratulations to Adam Silver and the NBA for launching their esports league. But those were moments for me where I personally got a look into the world of esports and what the potential of it going forward could be.
How has esports changed? I mean, it sounds like you brought a degree of professionalism and discipline to a sport that may have been the home of kids who, you know, had their eyes glued to a computer screen for hours and hours on end.
Well, that is the stigma, right? Coming out of a generation, an era where it was put down the video game controller and get out of the house, that was our era. My son, as an example, had a passion not to go into the family business of basketball, but to stay competitive himself, but in the arena of esports. My entrance was simply as rocket fuel as a parent to him. And so I can't honestly say that there was an anxiety around that, but as I explored and got deeper into where esports was growing to, my anxiety started to alleviate because no different for a young man or woman wanting to be a professional athlete in, say, tennis or basketball or some other field of sport. Esports is now giving individuals opportunities to get scholarships to colleges. They're having careers being professional athletes in esports, making a living for themselves. So some of that anxiety can go by the wayside, because if they do fall short, the industry itself provides coaching jobs, analyst jobs, broadcasting jobs, training jobs, sports psychologists. All of those career paths that reside in traditional sports are now being bridged together between traditional and esports, and we're starting to see now there is really no difference.
Hey, Rick, Tim Seymour, thanks for coming on. You know, I saw you in 2015 talking about how this was a massive business opportunity, but as an athlete, we play a game, would you rather? Would you rather cutting the nets down at the LA Forum, having won the championship, or being in the sold-out Garden for League of Legends championship and Echo Fox taking the title? What's more exciting for you?
Well, I've done one a number of times on the grand scale. I've won 3 world championships. If you know anything about my background, I've had really the fortune of being a part of great franchises, the Lakers on the Dr. Jerry bus, Jerry West, the GM, Phil Jackson, the coach. I play with great players like Shaq and Kobe. But all of those things I've accomplished looking backwards. I tend to look forward. And I think it really is going to be just as exhilarating, as exciting someday to hoist a trophy on the Rift. Something we don't get to do this weekend, but we hope to be at the Worlds later on in Seoul, Korea at the end of the year in League of Legends. And I know I'm going to feel the same way I felt when I won championships in the NBA.
Now, Rick, you've got something very special to show the world, right, this evening? Special jersey.
Yes. Well, this is our weekend jersey for our League of Legends team. We went with the Miami colors so that we can support the fan base here in Miami that love League of Legends. Our players are excited about representing them this weekend, and we hope you tune in to watch. I know one of your producers already and I had a conversation about his love for League of Legends.
Yep, she's a big fan. Rick, our thanks to you. Good luck. Good luck with Echo
Fox.
Much. Rick Fox, right, joining us from Miami.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.